In today's session, we'll learn about design procedure for knuckle joint. This type of joint is used for tensile application, where we join two rods which are acted by tensile load. Here knuckle joint consists of single eye, which is hollow in shape, and double eye known as fork. Here single eye inserted in double eye. Then we are having knuckle pin, which will be attached, and here there is also a pin called a split pin inserted through knuckle pin collar. So the whole assembly becomes a lock system. Here on single eye, we are applying load P, which is towards left. On double eye, we are applying load P, which is towards right. And this knuckle joint designed only for static load, not for dynamic load. So the major dimensions are diameter of a rod denoted as small d. Small t is the thickness of single eye. T1 is the thickness of double eye. And here I will denote small d1 is the diameter of single eye. And for double eye, the diameter would be same. Here knuckle pin diameter is equal to diameter of a rod, that is small d. Now let us analyze types of failures occur during application of knuckle joint. So here I make a table of various stresses induced in knuckle joint. So there are 3 of tensile stress, 3 shear stress and 2 crushing stress. Here minimum area of a knuckle joint is diameter of a rod, that is small d. So the first failures occurs at minimum area, that is tensile stress at rod, which is equal to load P divided by cross section area of a rod, that is pi by 4 t square. The next failures occur due to tensile stress at outside diameter of a single eye. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is d2 minus d1 multiplied by thickness of single eye, which is small t. The next tensile stress is at outside diameter of a double eye, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is 2 into dB minus d1 multiplied by thickness of double eye. So these are 3 tensile stresses. Now the next stress is shear stress. So failures occur due to double shear stress at diameter of a knuckle pin. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is pi by 2 d1 square. The next failures occur due to double shear stress at outside diameter of a single eye. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is d2 minus d1 multiplied by thickness of single eye, that is small t. The next failures occur due to shear stress at outside diameter of a double eye. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is 2 into dB minus d1 multiplied by thickness of double eye, which is small t1. So these are 3 shear stress. Now the crushing stress occurs at thickness of single eye. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is diameter d1 into thickness small t. Now the crushing stress occurs at thickness of double eye. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is 2 into diameter d1 multiplied by thickness small t1. So there are total 8 types of stresses in knuckle joint, where 3 of tensile stress, 4 types of shear stress and 2 types of crushing stress.